crying, talking about high school and graduating from it and such. So, graduating from high school, or like, that's what we call it in America, not high school, I don't know what you guys call it. But like, after top year, you guys call it?
Yeah.
The last year before you go to college or university or something. So that year before you go off to university or college, I've already graduated for that and everything already, and I'm already in college. Why am I signing? So I'm already graduated, and when I was in high school, I thought it was just, I was so excited to get out of there, and then when I got out of there, it actually wasn't the greatest thing. Really, oh my god, graduating from high school is gonna be the greatest thing ever, and I finally get to move out. Actually, I wanted to move out and everything, but I didn't. I'm still living with my parents, which I think is probably fine, because as long as they're okay with it, and they didn't push me out to stay with me. I have a job, I go to school, I take care of my own stuff, I buy stuff myself for my own money. I basically just use food, dishwasher, laundry, and just sleep there. And they drive me around sometimes. I have a car, I have my license yet, which is bad because I need to get it. I don't think it's, personally for me, I don't think it's the greatest thing because, once you graduate from it, you have this so much responsibility to come afterwards. You, like for me, I had to find a job. I had, to make sure I was, I'm going to school. If you're not going to go to school, it's kind of fine for you. You probably have to get a job or something. Honestly, you can't be a bum living in your parents' house the rest of your life. You have to do something. You have to get a job or go to school or do an activity or some sort, you know. Don't be a bum because bums really don't get anywhere in life. So, yeah. But like for me, like everything, oh, especially in high school, it's like the greatest thing ever. You get so much freedom. Actually, you get freedom, but yet you also have more responsibility on you since you are now an adult. Like you have to take care of yourself and everything. You're not a minor anymore. You're not under 18. You have to make sure you obey by the law, because if you break the law, then you go to jail and just like, hurt yourself. Like if you go to jail, that's on your current record, and they may be hard for you for your job, like something. Because like jobs, like people who hire you actually look at that stuff and say, oh, you got this and this. So what are those two felonies for? Like such. You know, but then there's the other part of it where it's like you get so much freedom. You get to do whatever you want. You get to, like, you have, I don't know, what, I mean, my curfew, I used to have a curfew in high school, when I was under 18, I had a curfew, and then once I turned 18, like, and graduated from high school, I have no curfew anymore. I sit longer than one, go out with friends, you know. But then I also have, but that's my responsibility. If I want to stay up till 4 o'clock in the morning, I have a 6 a.m. class, then I have to know that I'm going to be tired. I'm the one who did that, you know? So, yeah, there's that aspect of it. After that 12th year of school, a lot of hard, like, your teachers, like, honestly, in college, my teachers do not care if you show up or not. They don't, because they know you're old enough to take more responsibility for yourself and everything. Like, they don't care, they don't care if you turn your homework, they don't care if you show up, they don't care if you drop the class, they don't care if you drop the class, matter if you're failing or not, they don't care, because it's your life. You are the ruler. You are in control of your life. You're the one that calls the shots. From now on, once you graduate, once you turn 18, you are in control of your life. You are the one that makes decisions. And yes, there must be these little voices out there and there to direct you from somewhere, but they're not going to be there like every time. You have to make the decision yourself. And such, you know, yeah, for me, I didn't lose, like, the greatest. I was so great, like, after that day, I think so great, and then I got all this responsibility put on me, like, oh, what is this? You know, like, I like this kind of too slowly show you how to responsibility. Yes, I like that, because then when you get to the 18, you know what to do and how to do responsibility. But for me, I was that little bit, but yeah, I wasn't. I was immature. I've grown to be mature. I was immature during high school, between my 9th year and my 12th year. So, just think about it. You may be thinking, like, if you're under 18 and you're still in that 9th year to 12th year, and you're thinking, oh, I can't wait to graduate and do all this stuff, like, just, it may not happen, because you may not have the money or the supplies to get there. As long as you have the necessities to do all the things that you want to do, then you'll do them. But if you don't have them, then you may have to wait a few years, like I am. I am slowly trying to save up and get my own place, get a car. Yeah, so I think that's very much get a job. I think it's better to stay in your parents' house than just move out of there, because if you stay and save, then you have a much better plan instead of just going out there and just like trying to make the best of it and like not having enough food for the week or anything. So you get pay rent. So just think about that's what that will be like and everything. Just think. Don't rush into it. Take it slowly, day by day, and sooner you'll be there where you wanted to be. So yeah. So that's all I have for today. I will see you guys next week. Bye.